Bronx Nation, a 23-50 winner here, two starts back. Second in that maiden final last week behind the bush. Thank you, Mark. And thank you, Mike. Green lights on for race number two, Rockhampton favourite off the inside, Bronx Nation. Racing, he began fairly, beaten out though by Tax Loophole, who's going to lead quickly up to second as second gear, and around the outside, Little Mackerel with a good run. Whirly Blades in behind those. Bronx Nation out wide on the track, trying to improve from Fancy Benz. Look the part in the bushes, back last of all, taking over Little Mackerel, kicking back the outsiders. Tax Loophole, Little Mackerel and Tax Loophole go together, but Little Mackerel's now strode clear. Little Mackerel length and a half on Tax Loophole second. Bronx Nation got going late for third and fourth in second gear. Then came Fancy Benz with the bush, followed by Whirly Blade. Look the part was well back, and it will confirm the time shortly. It's quick again, 23-34. Little Mackerel, Kay Taylor, 770 and 230, got out to a good price on the tote. Tax Loophole second, 130, and Bronx Nation at 130. It's 7-2-1 and 3 is fourth, second gear in a red hot 23-34. The track's in very good condition, a length and a half by 5.5 margins. And Little Mackerel, at its third start in Rockhampton since coming from Victoria, has broken through. Son of Velocet and N. Campbell for Nadine Brown and Kay Taylor. Was up very handy tonight, and once it got into third and second in the back straight, was always going to be the one to beat. Tax Loophole, very consistent. She does kick on tenaciously, and she's run second again tonight for the other guy, Syndicate and Nev Jackson. And third to number one, Bronx Nation, for Darren McEwen and Christine Pollard. I'll admit I was worried about him from an inside box tonight. He won very well from box seven, winning his maiden. Didn't really appreciate getting crowded up last week, and realistically, he was probably never going to lead tonight off box one with speed drawn his outside. He did want to get to the outside in the back straight, but he did make up a lot of ground. Just look for him next time, or coming up soon from a wide box. I think that'll be Bronx Nation's best bet going forward. Okay, so we've got all clear, 7-2-1 and 3, a length and a half, 5.5 confirming mark.